Welcome to the CS++ series. This is the video series where we try to make computer science as accessible and approachable as possible to as many people as possible. If you don't know anything about computer science or programming, that is great. You are welcome to watch all of these videos. I just suggest that you watch everything in the 101 series before moving on to the 201 series. Now, I've given this episode a fair bit of thought, and this episode is the best online programming tools. And I have to be honest with you, there's really only one online programming tool that I can suggest in a very generic sense. That's Compiler Explorer. Now, when Compiler Explorer was first created, it was originally C++ specific. But it added so many more programming languages. It still defaults to C++, but it covers a lot of programming languages. And this is going to give you a little bit of a taste as to how many programming languages there really are today. So I'm going to walk you through actually using Compiler Explorer and getting started with it. As you can see, they do have a comprehensive privacy policy. And I've opened this in a new private browsing window so that you can get a sense of what it looks like to use it without any of my cookies or settings. Okay, so I'm going to close that, and it defaults to this C++ function. I'm going to go ahead and change this to Python. And note you can type in and search here, but it's again worth noting that this supports Ada, C#, C++, Carbon, COBOL, CVPX, D, Go, Objective-C, Ruby, Rust, Scala, TypeScript, Visual Basic, .NET. I mean, there's just a practically infinite number of programming languages here. But let's go ahead and move this to Python. So I'm going to click Python there, and you'll note that it changed. Now I still have a function defined here. And this is showing us what the compiler. So what we have here is source code, compiled code, and then we have this other window that we can open up down here. And I'm going to go ahead and click here, and we're going to see the output. Now, I don't want you to worry just yet what these terms source code and compiled code mean. We're just going to focus on making this into a little playground for ourselves. So let's go ahead and remove that. Let's type print hello world. And we have this Python program that is going to print hello world. But notice we don't get anything output down here just yet. So what we have to do is click on the output button and choose execute the code. And now we can see hello world is printed. And you can see that it is immediately doing the output for us. Now, if you want larger fonts, you can change them with these little drop-downs here. So if you want to choose what version of Python you are using, you can select that here. Or if you ever decide to toy around with any other programming languages, then you can do that here. Now, again, we're not focusing on like actually programming right now. I just want to give you this playground. So the point being with this, let's go ahead and recap. We want to choose execute. We want to type. And we chose Python to get there. So this tool is the tool that I recommend when you're playing around with programming. And for the moment, we're going to ignore this. All right, I hope you were able to follow along with that. Just rewind if you need to, but remember we also needed to click the output button to get this view visible right here. All right, I think that covers everything in getting started with Compiler Explorer. Now, your homework assignment is going to be a little bit more complicated. I want you to look up Hello World in the programming language Go. And if you need any assistance, what you'll end up with, something kind of like this link here, which you can pause this video and type in. But again, really the point is to get you playing. It is not going to be any kind of specific result that you need to have here.